Church is going on the inside, amen. Hey man, we ain't at the club and you take breaks between sets. We in church right now. We in worship right now. And the Spirit of God is in control right now. Amen. And maybe not you, but somebody else might be looking to receive their healing on Mother's Day. Their deliverance on Mother's Day. Amen. For this thing to function right, like your body, every part got to do its part all the time. Amen. Any part of your body break down, amen, at any point is going to affect the rest of it. Amen, 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 amen. We in worship, y'all. Amen. We over here in the house of God, but we still worship, amen. And God's everywhere all the time. But unless you have a lifestyle of worship, sometimes you may not be aware of his presence. Amen. But when you worship God in spirit and in truth, he'll reveal his presence unto you. No matter where you are, amen. No matter what you're going through, dealing with and facing. Amen. If we the people of God, we ought to have a God conscience all the time. All the time, amen. You're not just serving God when you're in church singing and ushering and preaching and deaconing and mothering. You're worshiping God, amen, when you're out there in the world. Amen. Amen. Representing him in your places of employment. Representing him even when you're in the supermarket, amen. When that conscience is in the back of your head and says, stand it for the lower price. But the Spirit of God says, have integrity and stand it for the right price, amen. That's worship, y'all. Amen. You know, worship is not really just when folk are looking at you. Worship is when ain't nobody looking but God. Are y'all with me? See, we can cut up and we can put on and everything else. Are y'all with me? Amen. Don't worry about Cameron. He's antsy. He coming in a little bit. Amen. Everybody sit down except the mothers. Amen. Except the mothers. We want to applaud the mothers today. Amen. I still hear mama praying. You remember that? Amen. We want to acknowledge all the mothers, amen. Hallelujah. Let's give every mama a hand clap, amen. Thank you. And we just want to let you know, mothers, how grateful, how thankful we are to y'all. All the love, all the labor, all the good times and the bad times you put up with us and prayed for us and seen us through, amen. Amen. I want to just let you know how grateful we are. Amen. Like I said, I'm glad and blessed to have my mom in service today. Amen. 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 Praying the Lord say so. God, a great day plan for my mama. Amen. And my sugar mama. Sugar mama not here right now, but we pray God's going to release sugar mama into us full time in this ministry. That's my wife, y'all. We didn't know. He's like, who is this sugar mama? Come on, brother. Amen. We got some gift and tokens for the ladies. Just to let you know, we were thinking about you. And we pray not just today, but every day you experience a blessed day in your motherhood. Amen. I pray all of y'all whose mothers are still in the land of the dying, because folk die down here. Up there, they never die. But if your mama's still around, make sure you reach out to her today. Show her great love and appreciation. She may not even be in the city, in the state, somewhere on the other side of the country. But you let your mama know, let your grandmother know, let your godmother know, let your stepmother know. Amen. Amen. Big mama, amen. Even big sisters. Some of y'all had big sisters who had to stand in the gap for you. Amen. Amen. Some of y'all got God moms. It's cold up in here. Amen, y'all. Goodness. Amen. Amen. I still hear mama praying for me. Amen. Praying. I still hear mama praying. And the prayers she prayed, keeping me day by day. Oh, I still hear mama praying. Amen. I still We have another tribute to Mother's Day, amen, on Mother's Day, praise God. And he's coming back to y'all, amen, in a special way. Amen. Y'all know him as Pastor Ray, Regina's baby son, Cameron, Bennett Green, amen. But he's coming to y'all again today as none other than Raw Praise, y'all. Come on and receive Raw Praise, amen. God bless you, y'all.
Have you lost your joy? Have you lost? His eyes go to and fro.
Today, God, we thank you for Jesus. Through him and because of him, we have forgiveness of every sin, cleansing from all iniquity. Thank you for the Holy Spirit renewing, reviving, and restoring right hearts, right minds, right spirits in all of us. Thank you for one another, sisters and brothers, coming together in friendship, fellowship, but most of all, uniting heart to heart, hand in hand, mind to mind, and spirit to spirit, to worship you in spirit and in truth. There's a collective blessing in this house when we come together, unite together on one accord. For then, God, you're there in our midst, and you're doing great and mighty things. And not just collective blessings, but every individual blessing today. The hearts, the desires, the needs of your people, God. You know what we need better than we know what we need. And thank you, God, you're Jehovah Jireh. You're the God who not just sees our need. You're the God who's able to supply our every need today. Big or small, many or few, God, there's nothing too hard for you to do. And so, God, we're thanking you. Even though we come in the house one way, we're going to leave another way, God. We're going to leave a better way, God. We're going to leave a blessed way, God. Edified, encouraged, and enlightened in your word, your will, and your way. Personally, God, I want to pause and publicly to say thank you for me, Lord. Thank you for another day, another chance, another privilege, another opportunity. Thank you for keeping me, covering me, providing and protecting me, God. Thank you for blessing me, even at times in spite of me. Faults, and failures, sins and shortcomings, God. You've looked beyond all of that because of your grace and mercy, God. You look to see and supply all that I need. And for your faithfulness to me, God, I want to holler back at you and say thank you, Lord. Now my mind is your blueprint, my tongue is your tool, God. Don't just speak to me, but speak through me. Speak your word into the lives of your people. Speak your word into that circumstance. Speak your word into the situation in any and every condition we face. In the house today, you'll be glorified. You'll be magnified, God. You'll be lifted up above any problem, pressure, persecution, and be edified. And we thank you for it all, in it all, through it all, God. We thank you for all you've already done, all you're doing right now,
all you shall do before we even realize in you, God, it's already been done. Even when eyes don't see, ears don't hear, even when it's not in the heart of any man, woman, boy, or girl, we who love you know that we know you have good things, you have great things. God, you have glorious things in store for us. And we say hallelujah. Bless you, God. Hallelujah. Bless you, God. Hallelujah. Bless you, God, for blessing us and how you continuously bless us in mighty, awesome, tremendous ways. Therefore, we give you the praise. And it's in the mighty, marvelous, magnificent, merciful, matchless, majestic name of Jesus we pray. The name of Jesus we praise. And through the name of Jesus, we always prevail. And we steal it because the devil no way, no how can steal when it's in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Let the people of God say amen. 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 Come on and give God personal praise this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. It's actually best praise this morning. Come on and give God personal praise. For the air I breathe, amen. For every step I take, glory, God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, it's word time in the house. It's word time in the house. How many of y'all excited about it? How many of y'all excited about the word today? You must not be dealing with nothing. How many of y'all excited about the word today? Amen. You must not be going through nothing. How many of y'all excited about the word today? Amen. You can take Excedrin and Tylenol, ibuprofen, oxycodone, warfarin, and all that. But I came to tell you that the gospel is God's pill that will heal any ache you ever feel, amen. Come on, y'all, tell you that, amen. One good dose of the gospel, amen. Because what is the gospel? Tell you, it's God's pill. You might not need that ibuprofen if you get the gospel, amen. Come on, you may not need that Tylenol and Excedrin if you get the gospel, amen. Because what is the gospel today? It is God's will that can heal any ill you ever feel, amen. Because this is my Bible, y'all. I'm holding it in my hand. I got it here in my heart. Excited, ecstatic, and expecting today. Knowing today is my day. S-O-S. Scoot over, son. Because after I hear the word, after I receive the word, and believe the word, and when I do what the word tells me to do, my life not going to never be the same. It's the word of God, y'all, strengthening me every time I get weak. It's the word of God, y'all, sustaining me. Everything I go through is the word of God, y'all, that supplies even more than I need. Because I know that I know that I know. And I'm not ashamed about anything. Because I know after I hear the word, receive the word, believe the word, and it's when I do what the word tells me to do. My life, my circumstance, my situation, even my condition, they will never, ever, 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 I will never, 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 never will I be the same. Never will it be the same. Tell you there, I'm never the same. In Jesus' name. How many of y'all really believe it and receive it and so give it all and right now praise? All right. Because the right now blessing deserves a right now praise. Tell your neighbor if you ain't ashamed about it. Say, neighbor, a right now blessing deserves a right now praise. Now, maybe not everybody, but is there somebody in the house that know that they know the Lord is blessing you right here? Come on, be blessing it right now. Right now while I'm in his house. God's at my house, y'all. Sunday, I came to tell you God's already in my Monday, amen. Right now, I'm in May. God's already in my June, July, August, September. So I'm going to praise him right here. Come on, right now, 5 seconds, 5 seconds. Four. Get your right now praise out. 3, 2. Right now. It may not manifest the Wednesday, Thursday. But when the doctor tell you you're healed on Thursday, say, I knew it, amen, at 8:35 on Sunday, amen. because the Lord blessed me with healing on Sunday, and it didn't matter till Thursday, I know.
Right now, amen.
Come with me, y'all got your Bibles, amen. If you know somebody around you, near you, they ought to have one.
Amen.
You need this now, next word today. Amen. The book of 1 Samuel. Amen. The book of 1 Samuel. Amen. Somebody.
Amen.
A pre-announced word. Did you tell your guest today, I don't know what my pastor's going to say, but he's been talking about what he's going to talk about.
Amen.
The 25th chapter of the book of 1 Samuel. I want to read beginning in verse 23. I'm going to read this from the Amplified version. The Amplified version. You may have King James, New International. Amen. Simple English Bible. They have many translations that we can get the depth and meaning of it. But God gives me this word to read from the Amplified version. 1 Samuel chapter 25. Beginning here in verse 23, when Abigail, she saw David, she hastened and lighted off the donkey and fell before David on her knees and did obeisance. She bowed to him. Kneeling at his feet, she said, upon me alone, let this guilt be my Lord. And let your handmaid, I pray you, speak in your presence. And hear these words from your handmaid. Let not my Lord, I pray you, regard this foolish and wicked fellow Nabal. For as his name is, so is he Nabal. For foolish and wicked is his name. And folly is with him. But I, your handmaid, did not see my Lord's young men who you sent. She says, amen. I pray you do not regard this foolish and wicked fellow Nabal. For as his name is, so is he Nabal. For foolish and wicked is his name. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, don't let a fool make a fool out of you. Amen. Don't let a fool make a fool out of you. Amen. Come on, you can take your seats this morning. Amen. In the spirit of Mother's Day, God gives us this now. Next word in recognition and honor of mothers, but as well as those of us who may not be mothers, God gives us this now, next word, to minister to us, amen, where we are and where he's leading and calling us to be, amen. Don't let a fool make a fool out of you, amen. The Spirit of God in this house, amen, this ministry and churches, amen, been reminding some of us and revealing to the rest of us, amen, that in all we face and all we deal with, we go through and experience, in spite of the challenges and changes, in spite of transitions and troubles, amen, in spite of possible problems and predicaments, that God has divinely, amen, prepared every step, every season, and every stage of our lives, amen. In spite of what we deal with, in spite of what we face, in spite of what we go through and experience, God has divinely planned and prepared for every step of your life, every stage, whether you're young or old, amen. Every season, whether it's good or bad, amen, God has divinely prepared it so that his purpose, so that his plan, y'all, so that his
promises can be performed in our lives, amen. Amen. It's when we are trusting God, amen. When I say trusting God, we're trusting God to the point that we learn to like unlikable things. We learn, y'all, amen, to love unlovable things. Because a divine decision has ordered our steps, amen. Even when it's not sunshine, but it's rain, amen. Even when we're not going through happiness, but we're experiencing pain, amen. God has divinely decided, and he has divinely ordered our steps for our lives. And amen, when you're trusting God, you know that even when it's not going good in your life, you know that somehow God can make a way where there is no way, and he can work things out for the good in your life, amen. Do I have a witness in the house today? And it's when you are destined for a divine destiny. And when I say divine destiny, you are destined to experience and receive everything that God has planned and everything that God has promised and prepared for you in life. And you cannot let a fool, y'all. All right. Amen. I'm going to preach it anyway. You cannot let a fool make a fool out of you. Amen. I think I ought to define this word today, fool, for us, amen. That a fool is defined as someone who lacks good, sensible judgment, amen. Are y'all with me, amen? A fool is who? He is somebody, someone she may be, who lacks good, amen, and sensible judgment, meaning they just don't have crystal good sense, amen. Are y'all still with me? A fool is someone who does ignorant and crazy and stupid and foolish things in life. Are y'all with me? Some of y'all looking at me like you may know a fool or two, amen. They are people who lack what? Good sense, amen. Because they do what? They do crazy and stupid and ignorant, amen. See, ignorant means you don't know, but ignorant means you do know, but you don't care, amen. Amen. They are, amen. They do ignorant and crazy and stupid, foolish things, amen. And I'd like to add, amen, to the other nouns because, amen, fools are not just foolish people, amen. Amen. A noun is a person, place, or thing, amen. And some of the people we deal with are fools. Are y'all with me? But some of the places some of us go to, that ain't good places, sensible places to go. But we still go, am I right about it? Come on, some of the things, y'all ain't gonna say amen, I'm gonna preach anyway. Some of the things, amen, we do, amen. In fact, some of y'all look like you got it on your face right now. You ain't thinking about taking Mama out today, because you got some foolish things you want to get into after you leave this place today. What the word is today, tell you the word today is you can't let a fool make a fool out of you. Are y'all with me? Amen, amen. See, amen. Some foolish things and people and places, you should not, amen, allow them to persuade you to be foolish, amen. Amen, amen. No, don't let a fool make a fool out of you. They'll push you into some things that you don't want to get into. They will pull you, amen, and get your will into some things. Are y'all with me? Senseless things that don't make no sense. Crazy, stupid, insane things. Are y'all with me? And it's not God's will for our life to be caught up with foolish folk in foolish places doing foolish. Amen. Hey, David, ain't God's will, am I right? Because all God has predestined for us, he has planned, he has prepared and promised, amen. And now you're going to allow a fool to, No, I had another word, but I got to find another four-letter word that starts with F. Okay, you're going to allow a fool to file it all up for you, amen. All God got planned for you. All God got prepared for you. Read his word. All God got promised for you, and you're going to let a fool file it all up for you. I think you need to touch your head and be a little apart and say, no, don't you let no fool make a fool out of you. Come on, let's get into this story, amen. In the beginning of this text, the Bible says the prophet Samuel has died. And after the death of Samuel, amen, David, at this point of his life, if you know him, he is on the run from King Saul, who is threatening to take his life, amen. Because now God, amen, he has rejected Saul, and he's going to remove him from the throne of Israel. And Saul has found out that David has not only been appointed, but he's been anointed to take his place, amen. And when you read this text, amen, it lets you know, yes, David was the man after God's own heart, amen. And now he's been appointed and anointed to be king, amen. But while, amen, he's waiting for his appointment, even after his anointment, he has an enemy who is threatening his life by the name of Saul once again. And so David is on the run, but thank God while he's running, he's not running alone by himself. You read the story, God has raised up 600 men to have David's front, back, and his side at the same time. Are y'all with me? And these 600 men who happened, amen, to be rolling with David, in this text, amen, they come upon a rural town called Carmel, amen. When they come into Carmel, amen, it is a rural town, but they, amen, are hiding out in the pasture of a rich man's ranch on his farm, amen. And while he's hiding out, amen, on this rich man's ranch and farm, amen, he notices that his farm hands are out here watching over the land for their owner, amen. The man's name is Nabal, amen. The text says that he is a very rich man. He is a man who owns 3,000 sheep, and he has 1,000 goats to go along with it, amen. And then, in all of what he has in possession, the text also tells us that he is married, this, amen, Nabal, to a beautiful, sweet, sophisticated, smart, and sexy woman, amen. Can I say it like that? I'm going to say he already said it like that, so he must going to say it again. I said he's married to what? A sweet, sophisticated, and smart, sexy woman. Now, brother, you know if your woman is sweet with smarts and sophistication and sexiness to go with it, you got something going on. Am I right about it? Amen. Tell your man he better applaud you right now. Amen. Come on here. Amen. Because they Virginia ain't here, but I blow my horn. I got a sweet woman, a smart woman, a sophisticated, and you know a girl is sexy. Am I right about it? Amen. And so Nabal has all this going on for him. But one of the problems that messes up Nabal's life, the text says, is because Nabal is a fool, amen. Come on, he's got a great business going on. He owns lots of property. He's rich. He has this beautiful, sexy, sweet, sophisticated, smart woman. But he's a fool. What is a fool? A person who don't exercise good sense, amen. A person who, amen, exercises ignorance, foolishness, stupidity, and craziness in their life, amen. And so as we read this text, amen, we read this text, amen, it lets us know that foolish people can get on everybody's nerves, amen. And y'all know what you always say, amen. Don't foolish folk get on your nerves. I'm saying you're intelligent and they up here acting ignorant, amen. Come on, amen. You sitting up here with sense, and they in the restaurant acting crazy, amen. Come on here. You walking around trying to be sophisticated, and they acting stupid. Y'all know, amen. Because we got a few of them in our family. I'm sure some of y'all got some in your family. Am I right about it? And they just get on your nerves when you got to deal with a fool, amen. And the only way a fool may not get on your nerves acting a fool, because you might be the fool that's acting okay. I'm a preach, Mother Jesse, thank you. But then, amen, it's springtime in the text, and the springtime is nearly summer now, Deacon James. Amen. In the summer, amen, the ranchers and farmers, they would shear their sheep, amen. Now, you country folk know what I'm talking about, right? Amen. That means they would, amen, trim and cut the wool off of their sheep because the summer was coming. It was going to be hot and humid, amen. And I know a little bit about this, that if the sheep get too hot and humid, that's why David would lead his down by the still waters to refresh them. Are y'all with me?
They have a way of dying of dehydration because of the thickness and heaviness of their wool. And so they would shear the sheep as the springtime began to turn into summer. But not only would they shear the sheep, but they would also slaughter some of the sheep to prepare a feast. Amen. And so now it's sheep shearing, sheep slaughtering time in the text. And they know that Nabal has thousands of sheep to be sheared, and he's going to slaughter some of them as well to have a feast. And David tells 10 of his most trusted men, go to Nabal and tell him we would like, amen, him to bless us with some of the meat of the slaughtered sheep he's going to slaughter. He says he should oblige us because we protected his sheep out there in the field. We protected his shepherds, amen, that no man came and stole none of them. No wild beast or animal like a bear, a wolf, a fox, amen, came and took them, amen. We made sure that he lost nothing at all, and he ought to be grateful to pay us back.
All right.
And send us some meat while we're out here in this field. He says, when you go to him, be very polite. Tell him, amen, how gracious we are for him and how thankful we are for him. Tell him how much, amen, we, amen, would be blessed if he would do this. And so his 10 men, they follow David's instructions and they go to Nabal, amen. They greet him very courteously. They tell him that David, who is now going to be anointed king after the removal of Saul, amen, he's requesting that when you slaughter some of your sheep, some of the meat you would send to them for your kindness in protecting your sheep so that you could have a lucrative year in business having lost none of them. And you remember Nabal, right? He's a fool, y'all. He's an ignorant, crazy, stupid person. Because he acts like he don't know David first. Read the text. He says, who is this David? Amen. He's a nobody. In fact, his daddy's a nobody. They're low life from a low land, from a low place. Amen. That ain't no good at all. Amen. In fact, I heard that he's on the run from his master and he needs to take his so-and-so back home. Maybe he can get something to eat when he gets back there. But you can let him know, I got a whole lot of everything, but I'm not giving him no thing. And the 10 servants, they're appalled, amen. They go back to David with long, sad faces. And they tell David what Nabal said. And David, with his sanctified holy tongue talking self, lost it, y'all. He said, I know he didn't. That's the clean version. He said, what? And he threw my daddy under the bus as well. And he said, we ain't no good, Lord. And after all we did to protect all he had, that he would suffer no loss, he won't act like that? Oh, no. Read the text. You know what he said, boys, strap up. We getting ready to have a ride-by, amen. They didn't have cars back then to do a drive-by, but they had camels and donkeys and horses to do a ride-by. Y'all ain't gonna walk with me. He told his boys, oh no, we're gonna strap up, amen. In fact, I got 600 of y'all, read the text. I want 400 of y'all to strap up. And the other 200, y'all just watch the stuff. And we getting ready to roll out to Nabal's house. And he said, everything that uses the restroom on the wall, cut it down that it don't use a restroom at all, amen. That's the clean verse. You can read what he really said. But he did say, if they can use a restroom on the wall, meaning the man, he said, you got to cut them down and don't leave nothing at all. And here David and his men, all 400, amen, they angry, amen. They mad. They getting ready to go kill everything. And Nabal's servants found out they were coming. And they didn't run to tell Nabal because they knew he was a before. Can y'all stay with me? But they went and found his beautiful, sexy, sophisticated, smart wife. Are y'all with me? Abigail. And he said, Miss Abigail, your husband done infuriated David. He's on his way here with 400 boys to wipe everybody out. And we would have went and told your husband, but he's a fool. He don't listen to nobody. He ignorant. He crazy. You know him because you married to him. He's stupid, ain't he? And he getting ready to get all of us killed. Abigail says, okay, well, we ain't going to say nothing to him because you know he a fool, right? Okay. But this is what I need you to do, amen. I need you to saddle up some donkeys, amen. I need you to get some corn. I need you to get some figs. I need you to get some raisins. Get some of them sheep, amen. Them goats, y'all done cut up and already dressed. And we're going to go out here and make peace with David before he get here and kill all of us.
All right.
And so they ride out, amen. And the Bible says they meet David out there on his way. And when Abigail meets David with her fine, sophisticated, sexy, sweet setup, smart setup, she jumps off of the donkey. She bows down before him. And she says, David, I know what you're thinking about doing, but I need you to rethink your plan. Because my husband, Nabal, who you getting ready to come slaughter, he's a fool. Because that's why they named him Nabal, because Nabal in the Hebrew translated to English means foolish, ignorant, stupid, crazy person.
Right.
And he just acted out the name his mama put on him. She said, but you know what? You can't let a fool make a fool out of you. Because David, God's got a divine destiny plan for you. God's got things that he has promised and he's prepared. You're getting ready to be the next king. And if you let this fool make a fool out of you, you might not never get to the throne. I know you're mad. I know you're upset. But I know also you know God, amen. And you know, David, amen, that if you hold your peace, won't God fight every one of your battles? If you turn that situation over to the Lord, won't he make your enemies your foot? Y'all ain't gonna shout with me. See, some of y'all ain't gonna learn how to deal with these fools, amen. Don't you know, amen, if you cast your care on the Lord will take care of you and your enemies at the same time, amen. Don't let 5 minutes of hatred mess up 50 years of blessings that's coming your way, amen. No, you need to rethink this, and you shouldn't let a fool, amen, make what? A fool out of you, amen. Come on here, somebody, amen. Because you get ready to come into your season, amen. And when you come into your season, you got to realize you ain't the same person you used to be, amen. No, you are all the way different, because when the Lord laid his hands on you and anointed you, it changed your status, amen. If David had Facebook, you'd go on there and say, David's status has changed, amen. Because when God changed his status, he also changed his situation, amen. And he didn't just change his status and situation, but if God lays hands on you, it changes your stock, amen. That means your stock rises up, amen, because you've been anointed by God, amen. And he says, if you go and do what you're planning to do, thinking to do, you're not going to be able to be the king, amen, because you're going to let a fool make a fool out of you. You're going to let a fool make a fool out of you. David says, you know what? He didn't really say it to her, but this fine, sweet, sexy, smart, sophisticated woman that made me change my mind. He said, boy, if I know we was getting ready to do this ride by, but we going down. We gonna let this fool slide. And what's your name, baby? Abigail, Abigail, I want to thank you. Because the Lord has used you to give me a word that was changed my life if I would have went through it what I want. You spoke to me and you calmed my anger. You extinguished my, amen, my hatred, amen. You made me not think about what I want. And I want to thank you. in his mind, he said, with your sweet, smart, sophisticated. Brother started walking away. You know how it is sometimes, bro. You have to, okay. Rides back off Joe, and Abigail goes back home and read the text. By the time Abigail gets home, Kenny, Nabal having a big feast and party. And he's drunk as a skunk, the text said. Because she wants to go home and tell this fool about himself. How he was getting ready to get all of them killed because of his stupid, foolish ways. But she knows, like many of us have to learn, if a fool is drunk, you can't talk to a drunk. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me right now. But y'all know you can't get no sense in a drunk. You know what you gotta do? You gotta let him sleep it off and sober up, amen. Because as long as his blood, amen, is 3.0 intoxicated, you ain't getting nothing in him. You know 3.0, some of us know 3.0, that's dead drunk, am I right? But she waits till the next day, and she waits till he sobers up, and he can understand what she's saying. She goes in the room and tells him, she said, Nabal, your crazy, stupid self, do you know you upset the man who's going to be king? Do you know he had 400 of his men strapped up, coming to kill everything that could use a restroom on the wall at our house? They was going to destroy you and me and everything we worked for, everything we've accumulated, everything, amen, we have. And it hit Nabal so hard, Ted said he had a heart attack. And from the heart attack, he slipped into a coma. Because he hadn't realized finally how foolish he had been. And the Bible says in 10 days, God stricken him. Look at the text, verse 36, 38. God smote him and he died. That fool died. He died. And this is the moral of the whole story. This is where we close. Because once again, when you are destined for divine destiny, God has plans for you. God has prepared promises for you. God's working out his perfect will in your life. Foolish things will come to tempt you. But this is when you got to realize you can't let a fool make a fool out of you, amen. Because if you slip in care and you slip in conduct and you start being the wrong person, ended up in the wrong places, doing the wrong things, everything that God planned for you, everything God has prepared for you, everything God, you don't fit that, amen. Because God don't want no fool sitting on his throne. God don't want no fool ruling and reigning over things. He done blessed y'all. And listen, amen. And every time, amen, once again, I know because I get tempted, I get tried, and I get tested, amen, to allow a fool to make a fool out of me. And you know after a fool make a fool out of you, the fool done went on. And when they start talking about folk after church, they ain't talking about the fool after church. They talking about the fool that came out of you at church. Reading this text, though, because they were saying, why would Pastor Green preach this on Mother's Day? You know what it is on Mother's Day? Because not only did David not let Nabal make a fool out of him, but Abigail didn't let Nabal make a fool out of her. She had to put up with this fool for a little while because that was her husband. She had to tolerate this fool for a little while because that was her husband. Y'all ain't talk. Okay, you want to talk to me, but you can't. Amen. I feel you. I'm sure she got down on her knees and was praying, Lord, do something about this fool today now. And if you don't change this fool for me, I need you to change me for this fool today. And do you see what Abigail did when she ran out there to meet David and
change his mind about coming to kill everything back at their house.
Amen.
You know what this woman did? She saved her family. She saved her fortune. She saved her future. Did you catch it, mama, from mom and dad? A woman who said, I got to save my family. I got to save our fortune. And I got to save our future from a fool,
amen.
I know it goes against the rules because that's my husband, and I ought to speak to him about what we need to do before we do, but he's not going to listen to me. And I know if I sit back, then everything we have is going to be lost. So she rode out there and met David and spoke to him, amen, with words of wisdom that turned him around, amen.
Oh, yeah.
And what did she do again? She saved her family. She saved her fortune. She saved her future.
Yeah.
And look at this, Lauren, look at this. Nabal had a heart attack, went into a coma.
And he died.
10 days later, the Lord smote him and he died. And David got the word, Nabal had died.
Right.
And you know what he said? Come on, Eric, he said, Right now, she's sweet, she's smart, she's sophisticated, she's sexy, and now she's single. And all this property, Got all that fool's money, At home mourning by herself, Fellas, y'all need to go talk to Miss Abigail and tell her I was a little interested in her. Are y'all still with me? In fact, bring her back to the castle tonight. We gonna lay it out for y'all and talk to her. Baby. Roll up to Abigail, read the text, say that it's right, I'm making this up. And they say, our master like you, girl. He said he wants you to come back. She said, and look at her, she's so hungry. She says, well, before we go, can I wash all y'all's feet off?
All right.
He said, no, we ain't got time for you to wash our feet. We thank you, but he waiting on you.
All right.
Man, that Abigail get back over there with David, and David lay that line down on her. Get down on his knee and say, baby, will you marry me? She said in the text, she said, I told you when you get into the kingdom, don't forget about your girl and him.
Right.
And Abigail became David's wife. That's what it says down there. Don't it say it down there? Yeah, I didn't make it to the name. He didn't make it up. They don't have a Bible. It's like I'm making this up right now. It said that Abigail, and he had another wife, because back then you could have the men you want to have, amen. And you know it was hard for David to pass up on a fine woman. And y'all remember that Sheba, the sister down in the jacuzzi, amen.
All right.
But then the text also says, amen, that Saul had taken away his daughter Michal from David and gave her to another man. Vic, you know the story. When David killed Goliath, Saul had promised to the man who kills Goliath, we're going to pay your family's taxes for the rest of your life. You're going to live in royalty all your life, and I'm going to give you one of my daughters, amen. And Mother Mary, Saul gave David his crazy daughter, amen. Started out all good, but she started getting on David's last nerves, amen, because she was like a daddy, amen. He was crazy, too.
Right.
Look at this, Mother Henderson. God knew Abigail was hooked up with a fool. He knew David was hooked up with a fool. And God orchestrated to move the fools out of their life and bring them together happily ever after. Woo, we are. Happily ever after. And you know the moral of the story. You just can't let a fool make a fool out of you. Once again, you got to do whatever you got to do to save your family, save your fortune,
and save your future right now. That ain't just for the mothers today. Come on, that's for everybody today. Because you allow a fool to make a fool out of you, you gonna mess up your family. You can mess up your fortune. And you can mess up your future right now. Some things you just gotta let go and let God. I know y'all want me to holler, but we got guests here today. They wouldn't understand if I started them being hollering. And I gotta wear this suit out to dinner with my mama today, so I can't sweat it out. But some things. And for fact, the Lord told me to specify for you a whole lot of things. You need to just let go and let God. He know what you're dealing with. He know who you're dealing with. He knows how you're dealing with it. And sometimes God don't step in real quick, real fast, real in a hurry. You know why? Because when we're tried, when we're tested, when we're troubled, somehow God allows that sometimes to develop our character. And it don't make us bitter people, it makes us better people. Some folk believe because you bite your tongue, you look the other way, amen. You don't do it in public. You wait till you get back in private. You a weak person. And you ain't a weak person. You a meek person. You learn. You don't let a fool make a fool out of you. You getting on my nerves in public, so now I'm going to get on your nerves. You cussing at me, I'm going to cuss at you. You acting ignorant, I'm going to get in nut, amen. And now after that, you done went on your way. I got to come back and try to pastor these folk, and I done acted a fool. Y'all ain't talking to me yet. Now you can let go and you can let God. And can I give you a word of wisdom? God will fight your battles if you just sit still. God will fight your battles if you just. Because sometimes that's what a fool, he know he's aggravated, he's agitating, he's getting on your last nerves. And that's what he wants, amen. That's what she wants. She wants you to keep cussing. She wants you to keep fussing. He wants you to keep crying. He wants you to, amen, keep saying, no, when you just let it go. You can say hallelujah, amen. Thank you, Lord. You're working it out for my good. Because the battle is not mine, God. The battle belongs unto. Y'all know how to deal with it. You got some foolish things, foolish people, foolish places. Just write it on a piece of paper, ball it up, and throw it in the trash can, and say, I'm giving it to you, Jesus. I'm giving it to you, Lord. I'm putting it. I'm putting them. Y'all look like y'all don't believe me. I dare you to try it. I dare you to try. To say, I'm going to give it because Lord, they're pushing me to that point. They're pulling me to that point. I'm ready to let them have it in this life. All right. And now you're on the brink of walking into the season. All right. That God's got plans for you, and you got 5 steps to get in, and now you're acting a fool that's going to set you back 5 years. Oh, my God. Did you have 5 more years to try to get back in the season you could have been in 5 days if you wouldn't have let a fool make a fool out of you? Come on, stand with me. Come on. You've been encouraged about 2 or 3 folks that don't let a fool make a fool out of you. Come on, don't let a fool make a fool out of you. Come on, you've been encouraged about 3 folks. Don't let a fool make a fool out of you. This is my season for grace and favor. This is my season to reap what I have sown. Can anybody help me with that? This is my season for grace and favor. How many already in the season?
That's for the people of God.
Don't you let nothing talk you out. Don't you let nothing get you out of character, amen. Don't you let nothing influence ungodly conduct in your life. You'll miss your season. You'll miss your season. You'll miss your season with your sweet going to church self. You'll miss your. Somebody in the house don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You have an opportunity, you got a chance today to get right with God. You got an opportunity, a chance to do it right now. He knocks at the door of your heart. He knocks at the door of my heart, our hearts today. He wants to come into our hearts, our lives to say. He wants to be our God, our Lord, our Savior. The director, the protector, the one who guides, the one who provides, amen. He wants to be, amen, the one, amen, who leads you and guides you, directs you, and protects you. And he can't do it without your authorization. He won't to, but he won't force himself into your life. He won't break down the door of your heart and say, I'm coming in whether you want me to or not. He'll just stand there and knock at the door of your heart. And if you just answer that knock and ask him to come in, believe on him, and confess him as Lord and Savior, he'll be your God, he'll be your Lord, he'll be your Savior. Simple as A, B, and C. What does that mean, Pastor Green? Amen. Yeah, he'll lead, guide, direct, and protect. But he'll save you not just right now, but now on, even over in eternity. Amen, somebody. Simple as I can make it, he will save you not only from a hell at the end of your life you can go to, he can save you right here, right now with any hell you go through. And that's why he knocked on your heart. He's got divine destiny for you as well. Just like David, Abigail, everybody else, God's got a plan, God got a purpose where things work out for your good, amen. You got to trust him. Today, he's calling somebody to commit and connect to his church. Not just the place of God, but commit and connect to the people of God. God ministers to us, amen, so that when we leave out of here, amen, amen, we can live and lead a life that God has directed and instructed and guided us to live here. Amen, because it's not easy living a godly life in an ungodly world. It ain't simple doing right things when you got alternatives to do so many wrong things. And let me ask you this question, people. How can God bless what you're doing when you ain't doing what God's blessing? God's not going to bless you because you need a little sympathy. God don't always bless us because we in seniority, amen. God simply blesses us because we stand on the word of God. And when we stand on the word of God, that's when we can see the God of the word take a stand for us, amen. And so that's why he said commit and connect, not just to come into this place, but being that kind of person, amen. And it ain't always a hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, amen. No, it's just living my life in line with God can bless my life. Today, somebody might need some help leaving up out of here. You might be like Abigail, dealing with some, amen, person you can't deal with, amen, and you can't tolerate, and you living with them. You working with them. You raising them. Amen. And God is calling you to be that kind of person in that kind of place, doing that kind of thing. Hallelujah. That kind of man, that kind of woman, that kind of husband, that kind of wife, that kind of father, that kind of mother. And to be that kind, you may be like me. You may need some help. You might need some help being that kind of husband, being that kind of father, being that kind of son, being that kind of pastor, being that kind of person. You might just need a little help, amen. And it ain't bad to need help, but you know what's real bad? When you need help, you don't get the help you need. Yeah, it ain't bad because everybody in there needs some kind of help. Don't let nobody fool you that you're the only one and you're going to look crazy if you step out there today. No, all of us need some kind of help. In this house, some need physical help, some need financial help, some need relational help, some need emotional, mental, spiritual help, amen. It ain't bad to need help, it's just bad if you sitting there, standing there, needing some help, and you don't get the help that you need. And who knows how to help you with you better than God who created you, amen. Amen.
something break down in my house, I don't need no jack leg repair, man. I'm going to call the manufacturer. They can tell best what's wrong and what needs and how to fix it. Why they manufacture it. And so maybe you going to try Dr. Phil and somebody else is going to try Oprah and the others going to try Judge Judy. I'm going to try Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to try the Lord to help me with me. Amen. I'm going to pray for the others, but Lord, help me with me first of all. Because you might not change them for me, but you can change me for them. They might not never straighten up. They might be like Nabal. They just going to die a fool. And I can't let a fool make a fool out of me. Amen. What a word, Lord. What a word. All right, we got 10 seconds for you to come down. I know you want to come. Don't be afraid of shame and temptation. You let go, let go, let God. That's how your breakthrough will break through, because you let it go. That's how your turnaround will turn around, because you let it go. That's how your change will change for your better. You know why? Because on March 8th, Mother's Day, almost 8:30, you let go and you let God. You can stand there, yeah, God see your need, but he said, come here and watch him supply your need. Coming here is called a step of faith. It's a sign, God, I'm trusting you. I'm trying to trust you with my situation, my relationship, my condition. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All we're going to do is pray right now. Counselors, ministers, helpers, they probably asked why you were here so we can pray sufficiently. Amen. But we're going to pray one with another for another. Different people down here, I'm sure they got different needs, but know this, the same God above us all is the same God who can hear and help us all. This is what I need you to do. Trust God for you, but trust God for the one next to you. And you don't even know them. You don't even know why they're down here. If you do know them, just say, Lord, bless them, because I'm asking you to bless me. God, help them deal with their situation like I'm asking you to help me deal with mine. God, you know I'm depending on you to fix it for me, but if anything's broken, my sister, my brother, this young man, young lady's life, fix it for them. Two or three of us touching the Greek, God's going to get right here in the midst, and he ain't going to just hear us. He going to help us, y'all. Those in the audience, you pray in faith, people, stretch your hands this way. Simple prayer. Lord, supply the people's every need. Lord, supply the people's every need. Father, it's in Jesus' name, God, we have extended your invitation. These are they who have come, God. Before they had come, you knew the need in their life. Now that they have come, God, you don't just see the need. My prayer is you supply even more than they need. However you do it, through the church, through the word, the Holy Spirit, believers, servants, and situation. Grow these folk in grace and in the knowledge of you. Place and put a hedge of protection around them, their eyes, their ears, their hearts, spirits, and mind. The enemies will not steal, kill, nor shall they destroy as you prosper, increase, and bless these people day after day, time after time. They've taken the first step to come, God, and I know if you help them take the first one, you ready to enable them to take the next one and the next one. And we thank you for it, Jesus. We pray in your name. Let the people of God say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. The environment changes. The atmosphere of your life changes. The cloud of blessing comes upon you, amen. To release goodness and mercy all the days of your life. Come on, anybody in the house want to give God a praise in this place? Amen. Come on, say anybody in this house, you don't mind giving God a praise in this place. Don't let a fool make a fool out of you, amen. Amen, somebody. I might be in here by myself. Because there are foolish nouns that can make fools out of you. People, places, and things. And sometimes it ain't other folk, other places, other things. It might be you on your own. On your own. Amen. Sabotaging your own life. messing up your own blessing this season from coming forward. Amen. Well, we're going to worship the Lord and give it before we get out of here. Glory, amen. Celebrate Mother's Day, amen. I pray once again, mothers, they applaud and acknowledge you for your worth, amen. Amen. For your goodness and your kindness and your love. And then some of y'all, amen, they feel.